When compositing effects, lighting can be key to get it to look just right. With our EXR files, you're given full customization by getting access to multiple lighting passes like key, fill, rim, fire, and more. In this video, I'm going to show you how to properly set up your EXR file inside of After Effects so that you get the most out of your ActionVFX asset. Let's get into it. So we have one of the directional explosions, and what I've done is pre-comp the explosion, and I have the key, fill, rim, and fire lights. You can extract it out using the extractor effect, and then you can go up here and set the appropriate layer, in this case being fill. And once you do that, you can see that the alpha changed, but the image itself doesn't look any different. What you'll see though is that once all these are combined using add, which is the correct way to do this because it's light and you have to add it together linearly, is you get a dark halo. It's just After Effects. The way that it handles this is it's adding all these values together, but it's using alpha channel information as well. So it's like the edges don't get added together in the same way the solid alpha does. It doesn't matter what color your background is, it's still there. So to fix this, what you wanna do is first add a shift channels. And you're going to say, take alpha from full on, and you'll see how those edges got brighter when adding that. And then lastly, since we have no alpha information, we're going to duplicate again, and we're just going to have RGBA. And this guy is set to stencil alpha. And that's going to punch out our alpha. And now when we go back in here, we have our nice edges. We can easily adjust exposure of something, like if we wanted less fire, we can throw an exposure on here and we can dim it down. And then at the end, we apply the alpha channel right on top. So let's say we want to take down a key light. Well, we can easily do that. And you can see that it starts to go away and we get a more evenly lit asset. But then it doesn't matter if you're on bright backgrounds or dark backgrounds, it's all going to look good and have the correct image. And that's how you set up our multi-channel EXR files. Let us know in the comments down below what tutorial you'd like to see next. Don't forget to head on over to actionvfx.com where you can browse the world's largest library of 2D and 3D assets ready for film, games, and television. With that said, get out there and start creating, and I'll see you on the next one.